Hi there everyone, welcome to my channel. I've had an experience with my Mavic Air 2 where the obstacle avoidance is constantly beeping and I'm not able to fly forward or backwards, and even though you turn off the sensors it still keeps beeping. So in this video I'll show you guys how I resolved it. First I'm going to show you guys how the issue displays itself. So when you turn it on, as you can see on the screen in the background, I have taken off now, but there's clearly no errors on the application. You can check in the pre-flight check, there's no errors whatsoever, and the obstacle avoidance are detecting something on the front and the rear, but that's normal because I'm still taking off, so there are obstacles on the front and on the rear. So taking off and going up to a height of about plus minus 25 meters, you can just see that it still detects obstacles. I'm well away from anything, so not sure what's going on. I'm not able to fly forward or backwards. Turning around just to make sure it's not the sun reflecting in the sensors. Still beeping, detecting something, not sure. So if you try to fly forward, because it picks up obstacles forward and behind, the app only shows behind, but it is definitely showing forward as well. You can see there. I can't fly forward or backwards. So I'll change from bypass to brake and just see what's going to happen. Still a full stick forward, backwards, nothing. Drone just does not want to respond. And the drone's in great condition, there's nothing wrong with it. It's physically perfect. So I've turned off the obstacle avoidance now, and now I can fly forward. I can fly sideways, I can fly backwards, you can see there. No problems, but that beeping just goes on. So at the very least you can fly with obstacle avoidance turned off, but you're gonna have to turn off the volume on your phone. That's the only solution to the beeping. Still trying to maneuver the drone, just figure out what's going on, and yeah, nothing's working. So hopefully if you go to sport mode it will turn off obstacle avoidance, right? And the beeping should go away. Let's do it. As you can see, still beeping. At first I thought it was going to be a bug, that if you switch between sport mode and normal mode, it'll go away. But as you can see, it's still beeping, and yeah, nothing you can do about it. So now let me show you how to fix this. Okay, so the issue is with the obstacle detection. Unfortunately, the beeping, I have no fix for that. If you don't like the beeping, you'll have to turn off your phone's audio. So first you need to download DJI System 2, I'll link it below. And you need to install it and run it and connect your drone to your computer or your Mac. Luckily the app automatically detected. Okay guys, so once you're ready to download the software so that you can calibrate your drone, you need to download DJI Assistant 2 for Mavic. Once you've found that, just search that. You'll find the download link. Once you've got the link, decide which one you need, either for a Mac or a PC. I am on a PC, so I'm going to select this one. Remember, this is for the Mavic 2, Mavic 2 Enterprise, DJI Smart Controller, Mavic Mini, and Mavic Air 2. There are other DJI assistants, but they are for different drones. So please check the supported products before you click your download link. If you click your download page over here, it will start to download automatically. I'm going to click cancel because I've already downloaded it. So you're going to click cancel and you're going to download and install the product. Once you've installed it, you can open it and you're going to find DJI for Mavic, and it's going to pop up like this asking you if you would like to make a recording or restart or for Mavic Mini. In this case, we are just going to close it because we don't need it, and you should get to this section over here. Once you're on this screen, then you can plug in your USB-C cable. I'm not sure if you guys can see over here, but a USB-C cable that came with your Mavic Air, typically the cable that you use to charge the controller. You're going to then plug it into the drone itself. So on the one side, you're going to find your little port. You're going to take the cable and you're going to stick it in there. Once that's done, you can turn on your drone. And it's going to power up. If you want to, you can put your drone down. But in this case, I'm just going to hold it like this. Okay, so the idea here is that it will automatically get detected. The drone's going to power up. It's going to pick up the SD card. You can ignore that. All we need is we want it to be detected by the system. You're going to click on the Mavic Mini or Mavic Air 2 icon. It's going to go into the software area. And if you need to upgrade your firmware, you can do this. In this case, firmware incompatibility detected. Some modules are currently, need to update. So if I want to, I can just click confirm. In this case, let me click confirm and I'll show you what to do. This is most likely because my one battery has not been updated yet. So it's going to go pretty quick. So it's not a huge update to do. But as you can see, DJI Assistant will check your software for you. And if you need to upgrade your firmware, it will do it automatically for you as well. So pretty good. Typically, if I was in the field right now, I would have powered up and it would have said firmware inconsistency found, which you'd like to update. And then essentially I would have had to update in the field, wasting some battery. So this is pretty useful to do. If you've got 3 or 4 batteries, I really recommend that you open or link it up to DJI Assistant. Just check, because what you're going to do is you're going to put one battery in. You're going to run through the whole process. You're going to take it out and then you put another battery in and you'll start up again. And if the battery needs a firmware update, DJI Assistant will tell you so. So in this case, we are just going to run through the software update and we can move on from there. As you can see, this would have taken probably around about 3-4 minutes in the field that your drone would have just been idle there. So pretty important step to do. Okay, once it's done, it's going to do the whole restart. Drone's going to calibrate, camera's going to go up, it's going to restart. Now we're almost ready to do the final step. Now remember, we are doing this because our obstacle avoidance is going nuts. And in my case, you guys could have seen in the video that I did not have any errors whatsoever. There was no indication that something was wrong with my drone. I just turned it on and none of the sensors were working properly. So now everything is restarted, the drone's connected, everything is sorted. This next step is very important, but very easy to do as well. So just gonna click back. The drone's gonna check the firmware again. Everything is now perfect. Click on the calibration tab on the far left side. Once you've got that, you can click calibrate now, but you can follow the instructions as well. So make sure your cord is connected to the drone. You'll click calibrate now, and it's gonna pop up. Now, what I like to do is I like to hold the drone by the back. I like to hold it like this and then use my one hand to just pivot on my other hand. So while the drone is held with my two fingers, just like this, nice and easy, I can just use it to focus on the screen. So you're going to move it closer and there's going to be little red icons on the screen or little markers to follow. Once it's there, you will just pivot the drone so that it matches all of the items. These little blue blocks you're going to follow. So this blue little block just means that you need to track the drone with that. Please do not move the drone, just pivot it in the same spot. So in this case, you can see again, it's asked me to move further back. Just follow the instructions on the screen and pivot the drone accordingly. Now you're going to do it twice for each sensor. So if it asks you to move forward, you go forward. I'm just going to wait for it to catch up over here. In this case, it seems it's going to fail. There we go, carries on. Sometimes it lags a bit, that's because it's taking some processing power. In my case, it's taking a lot of power to process this bottom left corner. typically it doesn't need to do that, but in my case it's now asking for quite some time to be processing this bottom left corner. There we go. Don't be too scared, just try and be calm and follow the instructions. In this case it's very very laggy on the bottom left side. And there we go, now it's nice and smooth. So I think my bottom left needed a bit more processing or configuration, so I think it's a very good thing that I did my controller. As you can see, it now says turn the drone to the bottom, so follow the instructions. Now if you take your blades off this will be a lot easier, but just follow the instructions on the screen and try and see if you can get the angle correctly. There we go, I've got it correct. This is a bit difficult sometimes because you're gonna have to try and view around your drone. But as you can see, you can just follow the screen. Just get my bearings right here. There we go. Takes a bit of practice to get used to this, but once you get the hang of it, it's actually really easy to do. You just, it's like playing a game, just follow the marker on the screen with the drone and then moving around. As you can see, I'm now going to the last step. The Mavic 2 Pro, for instance, you would have had side sensors as well, but with the Air 2, you only have front and rear, so just follow the instructions there. Sometimes you just have to wait a little bit for it to move up nice and close. Not detecting, just wait for the software to catch up. There we go. It took a really long time to load, so now finally it's got this. Now a lot of guys would have moved the drone away. Just stay calm and wait for it to catch up. It can take a minute or two for it to just load on the PC or the Mac that you're on. There we go. Second one's always further away. Now, calibrating your sensors is incredibly important because not only does it help the accuracy of your obstacle avoidance, but it also helps with the drone knowing how high it's off the ground or not. Quite easy, as you can see. Now you can just restart your drone. Actually, you can just turn it off. You should be done now. So you can just turn it off and you're done. Now that all remains is for us to test and to make sure that it's working correctly. The obstacle avoidance has now been recalibrated, so the beeping should be gone if there's no obstacles in front of us, meaning we should also be able to fly forward, backwards, left and right without any issues. What I'm going to do now is just change the obstacle avoidance back on. Go to brake, take off and see if everything's working properly now. Obviously there's an obstacle behind me still for the house, but in front there's nothing, and as you can see it stopped beeping. Finally, issue's been resolved. I'm able to use my drone again and fly around, and as you can see, nothing's beeping, I'm able to move around, no issues. Just checking if the sensor's not going to beep if I turn around, maybe the sun or anything like that. As you can see clearly, no issues whatsoever. So let's just check bypass and see if that works as well. Going forwards, going backwards, no problem. Great stuff.
just going to switch over to bypass and see if I can fly forward and backwards. Check a look at the speed at the bottom left. And finally, I'm able to fly forward, backwards, switch back to brake mode, and my speed is fixed. So yes, I can fly forward, backwards. If you're in bypass mode, naturally you're going to fly slower at lower altitudes. Okay guys, that's how I resolved the issue, by calibrating the vision sensors using DJI Assistant. So if you guys have found this video useful, please let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe.